Hey guys, welcome back to my channel which is Real Homeopathy. Please do like, share and subscribe to my channel and for more updates stay tuned and press the bell icon given below. So today I'll be explaining about the psychology lecture which is the third psychological lecture in my YouTube channel. So in order to understand this lecture you have to go through the previous lectures which I have already explained, and these are the clinical tips which I'll be giving on the psychological, how you have to analyze the psychological or the mental cases whenever it is approaching, the patient approaches you. So here I'll be saying you the point number one is arsenicum is irritated by untidiness but also by people who are unreliable. Whilst technetia is particularly sensitive to any form of rejection or criticism and will react angrily as a defense. So the difference between the arsenicum and technetia here. Arsenicum here is irritated by untidiness. So the next point will be tuberculinum and lachesis both love freedom and will not take kindly to being restricted in any war. So those patients who do flare up inner temper fairly regularly are likely to be one of the following volatile types. So the volatile types, there are certain remedies here. The first one will be anacardium, alumina, egnetium, lachesis, nux, mercurius, sulfur, cpr, stramonium and veratrum. So some staphylococcygria people are also very prone to anger, though only the wild type which is likely to express that, which is staphylococcygria. So nextly we will see very often the patient will willingly confirm this personal growth. There is an important tip I'll be giving you here is there is a personal growth whenever the person is having a changes, when he is believing that he will mentally change. But here there is a personal growth which does not change the constitutional type. Even the patient may change mentally or his personal growth may change, but the constitutional type which he is in doesn't change. What it says here, hence previous characteristics can be used in the homeopath's assessment. In this regard, I find that an inquiry into the personality of the patient during childhood is often very helpful. How the person is there in the childhood, you have to focus how the patient, how the person was there when he is in childhood, because when a person grows, he will mentally and he will, the personal growth of the patient will change. So this is very important when you analyze the case. Next one, in this regard, I find that an inquiry into the personality of the patient during childhood is very useful. So here there are two types which are likely to change. So which is only pulsatilla and calcarea children are likely to change their types as they get older. So these are the both people types who will change as they grow. Next one, the person who shows her child with love and affection, determined not to be like her cold mother, is likely to be natromure, whilst a man who drops out from society and professes to be indifferent to what others think of him. This probably belongs to the same type as this lycopodium father, who tried hard to make it in the world and always courted popularity. Okay, next one, there is one point here. Patient's profession can reveal a great deal of information, and this occupation or the profession what the patient does should not be ignored here. So arsenicum and natromure patients have good organization skills, which is organization skills, which is arsenicum and natromure, and are also found to be in administrative positions here. Next one, counselors and therapeutics are often found in natrams, being very good at listening to others but not so keen to talk about themselves. Calgary is often to be found in jobs that are either particularly oriented, such as a mechanic, or else in clerical and secretarial roles. So this is a Calgaria group. So Calgaria tends to avoid taking on too much responsibility and often accepts work well below his intellectual capacities or capabilities. Lycopodiums are often to be found in scientific and computing positions, in salesman jobs, and also in businesses in their own. They are also common in teaching professions. So this is all about the Lycopodium here. Artistic skills are seen most commonly in Lachesis, Natremure, Phosphorus, Silicea, Sepia, Ignatia, and Medorinum. So these are the things. Artistic skills come under this groups. Sulphur and Naxomica are the natural leaders and are unlikely to remain in subordinate positions for long. If they are not at the top of an institution, they are likely to be self-employed. Sepia is often attracted to the healing professions, particularly to nursing, physiotherapy, and other hands-on therapies. This comes under the Sepia group. Next, Pulsatilla. If she works at all outside the home, often chooses one of the caring professions, whilst Tuberculinum seeks either mental stimulation from his work or adventure. So these are the differences that you can easily catch out the person's, the characteristics. Based on his characteristics, you can recognize in which remedy his character suits better or his personality suits well. So this comes up about the Pulsatilla, the Tuberculinum, Sulphur, Naxomica, Sepia, and Calcarea groups, Lycopodium. Okay, next we will go. There is young homeopaths that should never believe that the patient says. What the patient says should never believe that. This is deliberately provocative and overstates the case. So what we should do here? Not only do many patients try to hide their weaknesses from the homeopath, many others succeed in hiding them from themselves as well. So often some patients hide the certain things or certain points that actually they need to expose or they need to express it to the doctor, but they tend to not express it. Delay it in expressing it to themselves, and they even unusual to recognize what they are suffering with. Nextly, I remember an interview with an in campus religious man. This all you can read by yourself. Next, I'll go directly to the next one here. Okay. Sex is a subject that many patients and homeopaths avoid here, yet it can reveal a lot of helpful information, and it is worth inquiring into. When the remedy is not clear, then you can go and dig it into the sexual matters of the patient's condition. So again, the attitude in which the patient responds is also very important, or it can easily portray the image of the patient. So sex is common with Natremure and Tuja, both of whom are prone to guilt feelings. On the other hand, an easy and even enthusiastic approach to the subject is often seen in Causticum, some Ignatias, Lachesis, Medorinum, Mercurius, Phosphorus, Sulphur, and Argentum Nitricum. So the rest tend to be in between. Lycopodium men often have issues about virility, which can lead to one of the several approaches to talking about the sex. If they are not aware, if they are aware that they doubt their virility, they may brush over the subject, saying simply, there's no problem there. They just ended the question by saying this. Nextly, you'll see, alternately, they may boast of their sexual powers, either directly or using the tone of voice in the manner of men's locker room exchange. Well, there's certainly no problem on that account. An honest and direct third approach is also quite often seen. Next one, these include there is a straightforward talking when talking about the sex. So these include alumina, baryta carb, china, the Calles, the Calligropes, the Phosphorus, Cilicia, and Stephysagria. This all come under that. They will probably exhibit some embarrassment when asked about. There is certain embarrassment when you ask about their sexual life, but this will not usually stop them from speaking about it. They will continually speak about that, but there is certain embarrassment in this group people. This is one helpful thing that you need to do. Next one, you'll see, sometimes it happens that the physical seems to favor one remedy while the mentals favor another. Sometimes there is a physically one remedy and mentally there is one other remedy suggesting. So in the experience, in chronic conditions, the mentals tend to be more reliable in helping to find the correct remedy when the two don't agree. When mental and physical don't agree, the mentals can be taken, the mentally remedy which is more suited, that can be taken, and it will help at a greater extent to the patient's relief. There will always be physical symptoms of any given remedy that are not familiar to the homeopath here. There are typical cases of just about every type from the mental point of view. The essence is a theme that runs through every aspect of the personality, such as the physical insecurity of arsenicum. There is physical insecurity in arsenicum. There is a single strange, rare, or a peculiar mental trait can reveal the correct remedy. The hand washing compulsion of syphilinum is a good example. There is compulsion of hand washing frequently. The person, it is also called as obsessive compulsive disorder, OCD. So in that case, you can think of syphilinum. This can be the best example here. Every homeopath must realize that information that is volunteered by the patient is far more reliable than that which is given as a response to a specific question here. There is one example that is given by the author. Next, we will see how there is another saying that during a good homeopathic interview, the patient will laugh or cry at least once. Although not literally true, it expresses an important point that the interview should be of sufficient breadth and depth to reach the heart of the patient. All too often, homeopaths obtain a superficial and misleading impression of the patient personality by failing to do well beyond the immediate replies that are given. This may be due to laziness on the part of the homeopath, but it is just often due to fear of embarrassing not the patient but himself, and to be feeling uncomfortable with the expression of the painful emotions. The more a homeopath is in touch with and comfortable with his own self, the more easily he will win the confidence of his patients and discover the real person that lies beneath the appearance. So this was the psychological tips for today, and in the next class I'll be beginning the remedies, which is particularly in detail I'll be explaining about the single remedies which comes under the psychological information here, which is more or likely to be like Alamina. There are many lot remedies that psychologically is helpful for the patient. So in the next class I'll be explaining about how the Alamina patient will be there, what is the condition of the Alamina patient, how you need to analyze the constitutional types, how you need to approach the Alamina patient, and what are his signs, what are the exact approaches that you can do by seeing this Alamina patient. I just want you all to stay tuned for the next class, which is on psychological, and I'll be dealing with the particular remedies in detail. And if you are new to my channel, then don't forget to press the bell icon which is given below. Please do like, share and subscribe to my channels, and give a thumbs up for me to be motivated to make more videos for you all, which is on homeopathy and medically allied subjects. I thank you all for staying up with my with me throughout this lecture. Thank you.